My son, Junior, stand up. Yeah. He does all our social media, so all the stuff you've been seeing, that's him.
100 mil, I need it. The glory, I need it. I took L's but walked around like I was undefeated. I saw no results, I still woke up and chased them. They told me to find myself, instead I want to find a way.
We're going to work. We're going to work our butts off and get this thing right. Right now, I want to hear, we're going to start with the offense. Offensive coordinator is going to get up here and tell us what transpired yesterday, and all the position coach is going to assess their positions.
Yards passing, 5 touchdowns, 132 yards rushing, 1 rushing touchdown. The biggest factors that we did not control was the controllables. We had 5 total penalties. The very first play of the game, we had a false start. We had 2 critical holding penalties that slowed us down, and that cost us from getting points on the board. We came out in the second half, and we did not execute our jobs the way that we are capable of because of a lack of discipline and a lack of focus. I need to do a better job of putting you in a position to be successful, all right? But I'm going to call the game to win it. Coach gives me the right to call the game to win it. So when it's 3rd and 4, I'm calling the game to win it. And I'm going to put the ball in our players' best hands for us to execute because that's the confidence that I have in y'all so that we can call the game. And that's never going to change. We need to pour into our work. Yesterday, we let the game get away because we were capable of scoring 50 points, and I didn't put you in a position to do that consistently, consecutively. That's on me. I'll be better. I challenge each and every single one of you to be better with the basic things. Don't be bored with the basic things. When we go back and we watch this tape, it's going to make you sick. The basic fundamentals that we did not execute in critical situations to end this game early and often so it never got to the point that it had to get to.
Tale of two halves. But at the end of the day, defense is about one-on-one matchups. Plain and simple. No matter what you call, you got to win one-on-ones, whether it's up front or in the back end. In the first half, we won the one-on-one. Held them to, 130 yards. Second thing I see, and this is the entire team. It's everybody. All right, coach is a disciplined person. Discipline is I know what I'm supposed to do. Can I make myself do it? I know what I'm not supposed to do. Can I make myself not do it? We had 4 substitution penalties in the game. 4 on defense. Critical penalties. Okay. Our job, we know when we go in, whatever the personnel grouping is, I signal going in and the entire defense signals. Now, one time on one of those 4 plays, did that happen? You think that's just those plays? No, it's every play. I know I'm supposed to play this guy on the divider. I don't play him on the divider. I know I'm supposed to long stick on Boston, and I don't long stick. It doesn't take but one person. And then penalties. Penalties. When you give teams extra plays, it's going to burn you. And we had critical penalties in the game, whether it was in the secondary, whether it was pass interference, whether if it was lining up off sides, right? That's now 1st and 5 is different than 1st and 10. You can't play the game that way. But the most disappointing thing of everything was in the 4th quarter. When we have an opportunity to win the game, no matter what the circumstances are, you watch the 4, you go back and watch it. There was absolutely no fight to get out of it. None. Front 7, back. No fight. No sense of urgency to say, you know what, stop this, I'm going to stop this. And as you watch, you will see. Now, the only way you get better is if you're self-critical. The only way you get more discipline is you. How you do anything is how you do everything. If you walk in this meeting a minute before coach gets here, that's saying, you know what? That's not important. Well, if that's not important, until we learn those things, okay, it won't make a shit what we call offensively or defensively or in the kicking game. It does not matter. It will always be that way. It will always be that way.
And it goes back to the same stuff. During the week of practice, if you don't get to the quarterback or if you don't wrap somebody up, or if you don't strain, or you don't get out when you gotta have fucking contain. First half was very, very good. The second half, it was fucking absolutely puke. End of story. And I'm gonna show you why. I will promise you this, it's not gonna ever happen again. Everybody got my drift?
Yes, sir.
Not on the corners, the whole secondary. I just felt like when it was time, we didn't make the play, man. Whether it was a catch and run, at the end of the day, we got to make the tackle. With the middle field safety, you got to make the tackle. Corners, we got to do a better job. Everybody understand, man to man. That's what we thought we was going to play this week. That's what we went into practice with this week. We're going to play man to man on these guys. And we gave it up. Expectation. Can we live up to it? Playing within the moment. Who are we? I still sit back and think about it, you know. Man, Coach Kelly can call any player in the world. At the end of the day, you got to execute. I mean, what else you want? What more you want from a coach? But at the end of the day, I think Coach, somebody just said, you got to look at yourself. Who are you? How can you help this team? It ain't about the big things or making the big plays. Can you do the little things right? Can you show up on time? Can you be at breakfast? Can you do the little things? Everybody want the fame. Everybody want the fame. But guys, it's not gonna happen for you until you recognize and realize who you really are. Not as a football player, but as a human being, as a person. What you willing to give up to gain something? What you willing to sacrifice for the next man? Everybody want to play. But I don't see too many people giving it up for their brothers. I don't see too many people sacrifice, looking themselves in the mirror and saying, what I can do better to help this team win. Because at the end of the day, it's everybody. And I ain't just one person. It's everybody. But that team believed more than in you. You were down, you was up 29-0. But that team went in the locker room and they kept believing. Did we do that? Not just offense, not just defense, everybody, did we believe? And that's the sickening part. That's the hurting part. Because we know we better than what we put on the field Saturday. So make sure that this week, yeah, it's a bye week, but make sure that we focusing on what can we do to get better. What can I do to get better to help this team? Hell, you may not be a starter. Who cares? Who cares? But what can you do to help this team, man? If you can't do nothing, then why are you here? If I can't do nothing to help this team win, why am I here? That's the bottom line. These coaches can't play for you. They get up every week and give you these speeches. Okay, so what? It's up to you to go play. You ought to get tired of somebody motivating you to do something that you say you love to do. You can get seriously injured out here. You say you love it. Why don't you put your all into it? See, I'm not a big talker, I'm a big observer, and I look at a lot of you guys. And a lot of you guys just wear the mask, man. It's a fallacy. It ain't reality, it's a fallacy. So you say you love it. Put your all into it. See what it gives you back. See what this game gives you back. And stop cheating the game. If this football, it's one game you can't cheat. If it don't get you in the wash, it's going to catch you in the rinse. So if you don't put the work in, don't expect nothing from it. Don't expect nothing from this game, man, if you don't put the work in. If you don't put the work in practice, if you don't get picks in practice, you don't get sacks in practice, you don't get tackles for loss, you don't break tackles, you don't make the plays in practice, why you expect to make the plays on Saturday? This game don't owe you nothing. This game going to keep going with or without you. Been going for 100 years now. It don't need you. You need it. So make sure you know what you need to do every week to get the result that you're looking for. Because we, instead of preaching, instead of begging some of you guys to come along, we just begging. We pulling you. We pulling you to do something that you say you love to do. We begging you. For the life of me, I don't understand why I gotta beg you to do something that you say you love to do. You say you wanted to change your circumstance. Some of you guys got situation. Some of you guys got kids. Some of you guys got a mother to feed. and you say you wanted to change your circumstance, but you treat it like this. So you really need to look at what you're doing and why you're doing it. Because you can go be something else in life. You ain't got to play football. You could be something else in life. But to play football, you got to give it more than what you're doing. If you want to change your circumstance and your situation. The game been good to me. The game been good to me. And we're going to continue to work our ass off as coaches to help you. That's what we do it for. We're doing it to help you. So make sure you're doing it to help yourself.
Now, yesterday, the second half flipped over to our first half because we got all giddy, we got all hyped up, we got all arrogant in the locker room at halftime. And we felt that as coaches.
You never put it on top of your head? You gotta put it on top of your head, Chad.
Tigger
got the new
iPhone,
you know.
They got the new chain. I like what he's doing.
Out of here, boy.
I like what he's doing.
I came all the way for Tampa,
boy.
Okay, then.
What's going on with y'all, man? Big tune. Let it tee up, man.
Here, DJ. Nope.
And we gonna go out there like this.
Every man.
I'm out there 13. Yeah. Unplanned activity.
Unplanned activity. He right here, yo.
What y'all doing? What y'all doing?
RCB.
Y'all doing shit without me. What y'all doing?
I'm a gangster. RCB.
RCB.
That's not my name. RCB.
That's
not my name. RCB. That's not my name. RCB. That's not my name. RCB.
I know you're not gonna hide these. You can't hide all this, man.
I know you're not gonna keep those shorts on.
This is what they call a blessing right here.
We got him out here.
You hurting my eyes out here, baby.
No, not me, not me.
You tell me this ain't Georgetown. This is the new Georgetown. Yeah, everybody know what I'm talking about.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
All right. Good?
Yeah.
Just chilling.
How are you?
Just having a great day. Just, you know, getting a little stretch in.
Yeah.
You know? Getting warm because it's pretty cold out here.
Any words for tonight?
Any words? Two go crazy.
I love it.
Number 12 is going to have two touchdowns. I don't know how, but he's going to have two touchdowns.
I love it.
Saucy QB go!
Saucy QB go!
Daryl,
I think he is, man.
I'm just at the game, bro. You know, I'm trying to get fly, bro. I can't get fly.
I see. Okay.
I'm trying to do a little something.
Keenan Holman, everybody. Keenan Holman. Bolton Hammer. SMU, he was at school for 9 years at SMU.
I was not at school for 9 years. That's crazy. Stop telling people that.
He did COVID years back in the day before COVID, guys. So that's Ken Owen right there.
Is you shitting me?
Forever shitting me. Ain't my wrist is sick. The sundown, I'm on the E-Way. I'm out.
No, you got the grill in it. I got you.
I'm tired in a bit.
Why don't you play fullback, bro?
Let's go, baby.
Yes, sir. I think I do want to play fullback, too.
That's what the streets want, bro.
I might do what the streets want.
Yeah, that's what the streets
want. I might do what the streets want.
They said when all go, they had to bring them out.
Mm.
Yeah. Hey, shout out to all Money Grills. Put your money where your mouth is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Saucy! I got 80 cameras on.
Catch him!
One-handed being good.
I got the city hot.
I got control up in the school. I'm still calling a shot. Saucy Big B!
That was awesome.
I'm ready to see that
bitch. Where you go?
I need Vaseline on my lips today, boy.
Woo!
Hey, this is the birthday game. You know we gotta do something. You know we gotta do something. I'm gonna meet you out.
When was your birthday?
Yesterday.
Happy birthday, man.
Appreciate you. I'm gonna meet you over there.
How old are you?
23.
Yeah.
Like LeBron.
You wanna see me get up already?
Yeah, that one up.
What's that supposed to be?
Oh, AC.
You the good one?
Oh.
Go ahead.
I go, I
like that one, too. What the fucking lights are blind your ass, boy.
Oh, you're
damn
near. What's up? Oh.
Hey, Bishop, okay.
Okay.
Hell yeah.
Best hands on the team, bro.
Oh, no. Don't label me as that until I get a touchdown at least.
I got you.
At least. I didn't know you'd do that.
Oh.
Yeah, fish out.
Hey, Folsom Field, Friday night, national TV. It's all on. Yeah. 60 minutes of hell. Let's go.
Over here, coming out.
50. That's my right. number of the day.
All right.
Who's going to score 50 points?
I got early. Okay. Early. Yeah. You got to compete early. You got to come out fast. Strong. Start the first half out strong. Yeah. Let's win today. Yes, let's make it about us. Yes, we're here.
Yes,
Let's go. Come on, baby. You know what that is. Stanford's got nothing. Nothing. Strap in. Strap in. It's going to be a game. It's going to be a game.
Fucking day, boy.
No
all day. Let's go.
Come on. Come on.
Let's go. Let's go.
Come on.
But I seen it when our man played the cards.
Let's go, bro.
Let's go, some trouble.
We're going. Good luck. Let's go, coach.
So. Since I said that I don't have ice in my veins, I ain't cold.
Woo. I got something to say, bro.
I ain't cold right now.
I know who's making it so cold.
Look at this.
Oh, you know this?
Yeah. You're bringing the temperature down.
It's about y'all. It's about y'all. It ain't about me. Hey, bro. I believe you're going to turn up today, bro.
Oh, yeah. You know, I ain't got to speak too much on it, man. I'm putting it in God's hand. Let him do it.
Yeah. What's up, man?
There's only one word today. It's only one word. Now.
Let's go.
Now.
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 Now. Now. Now. Now.
Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now. Now.
Now. Now. Now.
You're not cold at all?
Not cold at all, baby. You already know this. No sleep game. No matter the weather, no matter the temperature, rain, sleet, snow, no sleep. That's how we get down.
Let's go. Mr. Rick. Let me see.
Let's go, Hank. Oh, wait a second, I got something else for you.
Oh my God. You next level with it, Mr. Rick. You next level with it. Woo! That's hard. Hold on. I love it.
I'm never gonna change, bro.
Huh.
I'm gonna have a Cardinal for dinner, bro.
Hey, no.
I said it about the Sun Devils too when we won. I didn't change.
Oh, no.
I see you working back there, Quinn.
Hey, you know what I'm saying? All time we working, baby. All time.
You like the sassy shirt?
Bro, you saw that shit?
Yeah, I love
it. It was crazy, bro.
It was
crazy.
You know what I'm saying? They said it's cold out here. I know it's cold out here.
Every week we sit down with your boss and talk about the big wins and the important stories within the CU Athletic Department. Catch us on Altitude Sports every Wednesday night, the Pac-12 Network every Thursday.
I told you it looked good.
I wish you was out here, man.
I wish I was out here too, man.
Free Tyler Brown.
I'm just happy to be out here with my teammates, man. But free the Rock, free TB, just happy to be out here with the guys.
Turn up on the
After you followed us on social media, be sure to show off your Buffs pride on Facebook, Twitter, and
National Promise. Tomorrow, look up to see the beginning of something big, a solar eclipse that kicks off an exciting year of solar science. Sifu Boulder has been a leader in solar science since 1948, when scientists for the Laboratory of Atmospheric and Space Physics began launching rockets to make the first landing its 75th anniversary, and continues to launch instruments to study the sun, making it one of the premier solar science research institutes in the world. Last, scientists monitor how much light the sun emits, how it affects space weather and Earth's climate, and how other stars shining on other planets differ from being visible from North, Central, and South America. We'll also be watching on April 8th, when a total solar eclipse will be visible in parts of North and Central America. Using instruments in space, we remind you to drink responsibly and enjoy the game. To connect with over 300 colleges student athletes. Signing up is totally free and takes just a
sauce is sick, baby. You seen it?
Yeah.
My boy 12 free.
Yeah.
He ain't locked up no more.
No, man.
It don't feel dog.
That's how I show up in front of people, man.
So what? Today's first half by FNBO and Wrangler. A senior from
every day now, bro.
I don't even know how to be on the camera. I don't know how to do it on the camera. You know
how you good? You know how to do shit, bro. I know you look good.
From Oxford, Michigan.
There he is, right now.
Got on all that.
Word of the day?
Word of the day?
Word of the night?
Word of the night, yeah. We're going to go with Hoskins Slaughters.
Okay.
That's the, I think it's the bone right here, right in the shin.
Okay.
Shout out Sexy Red. My line. What you saying? What you doing? Put your back into it. And let's have a day today, man.
Special Olympics
it's the best safety in the world right here.
Yeah.
We also know that accelerated victories sometimes lead to fans wanting to enter the playing area after the game.
Believe it, man.
Which is against the university.
What safety do you know can play wide receiver and quarterback?
You cannot jeopardize the safety of players, coaches, staff.
No. Hey, wait till the end of the season. We got a trick for y'all.
So please respect the boundaries and do not rush the field.
Buffs fans, let's meet today's projected starters for your Colorado Buffaloes. Amari McNeil. Number 12, Travis Hunter. Number 21, Roderick Ward. And quarterback, junior, number 3, Omarion Cooper. And Hunter, junior, number 15.
Hey, he needs to get arrested. He needs to get arrested for that, officer.
I got you.
Number 16, Alejandro Mata. Jimmy Horn Jr. Graduate student, number 10, Xavier Weaver.
Hey, dear Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for my family. Thank you for my brothers.
And
let's play in your name today, God. And let's show everybody what we really do. In Jesus' name, pray.
Number 69, Jared Christian Lichtenhand.
Let's get this shit going, oh God. SOB on 3. 1, 2, 3. SOB.
Real
stepper.
Number 65. Jack Bailey. At center. Sophomore.
Let's do it, man.
At quarterback. Junior. Number 2. Shakur Sanders.
It's a good job.
Dear Father, we thank you for this day. Thank you for our families. Thank you for our mindsets. Thank you for the courage you've given us. Thank you for our head coach. Thank you for this great game you've given us today. We'll put the victory in your name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
knowledge and wisdom to make the right decision. Make it perfect, and God, let there be no injuries. Prevent injuries on both sides of the ball. I mean, both teams. Thank you, God. Season on that.
At this time, please direct your attention to midfield 49.5.
Look at they played that home too late.
Way too late. Mini man, I'm down on half a hill.
Mini man gone. Mini man ran on the field already.
Mini man was gone.
That was I heard this week.
Gentlemen,
you good?
Welcome to tonight's ball game. You're going to call me coin toss. Gentlemen, we have heads at Statue of Liberty and tails at the telescope. It is the visitors you're going to call. It's a heads. Colorado, you're going to talk. What do you have to do?
His boys. I know his heads. I didn't have to look.
Yeah. He don't play video games.
Huh?
He don't play video games like that, so he don't know.
Sanders pass pass complete.
Let's go, Jimmy.
Third and ten.
Don't do that ever again. Yeah. Disrespect that boy like that. The people's out there. The kids in the spin.
It's a hell of a spin move, boy.
What's gonna happen?
To see what Excel Energy is doing in your community.
You know what time it is. Let's go.
Hey, I love it. Hey, you want me?
Don't fuck it over. No.
Yeah. Derek Shiesty in the building.
12 men on the field.
I see. First and five. Get him. Who was it?
Daniels sacked.
Their first quarter, 14-0.
Two stellar specs. Out where no other mascot has rolled, she carries Sea Boulder's tradition of excellence.
Lucky in the building. He's got the gloves on. He's got the, hey man, you can press the iPhone with the thing. He's got it on. Hey, Andy's got the nails done. You know what it is? I see you.
Second and goal from the 16. Almost, boy. Almost. Thank you.
score. We ran a seat that we threw it to. We each other.
Way to go, we.
First and 10, first and 10. Good stuff, fellow.
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh no!
Your support last year was a big impact on our run to the Sweet 16, and we look forward to seeing you all at the CU Men's Center this year.
Hey, you slipped. That's all it was.
16, second and 16. First and 10. Okay, Jimmy.
It ain't over, it ain't finished. So let's talk to them about how we're gonna finish this thing.
Hey, what were you
shirt down right now?
What do we say about Dominate? Dominate is not paying attention to the scoreboard. I'm dominating my body. The guy I'm lined up against, all right, we ain't backing up. You got to play. Don't look at the scoreboard. Play.
Pain, bro.
Guys, it's our brand of football, right? It's our brand of football, one play at a time, right? Who are we going to be each and every single moment? You get to decide what our brand of football is. Smart, fast, tough, disciplined, with character. So regardless of what the scoreboard is, like Coach is talking about, go finish the job. Job's not done. One play at a time. If you're a starter, it's your job this quarter to be fucking dominant so the man behind you who's worked just as hard as you gets a whole to play so that they can make plays. And when you go in, the standard doesn't drop. The standard's the standard. Be physical, be disciplined, be dominant, one play at a time.
Smart, we get the ball, we get the ball, so you know what we plan on doing. When we gonna do it? When we gonna do it?
Now.
When we gonna do it?
Now.
When we gonna dominate?
Now.
When we gonna do it?
Now.
Let's go do it.
Let's go.
Third and ten.
Sanders pass the
ball. Fourth and two.
Oh, yeah. Come on. No.
Sanders sacked by number zero. Bernadette,
number 92, and it's perfect. It's 3-0? Oreo! Interception right here.
Turn 42, EJ Smith, the ball game. Tackled by
3-3,
Trevor Wood.
Second and four, second and goal. Get him. Third and two. First and ten.
Go with Go Shrive.
4 for 4.
Stanford 19.
Nope. We did terrible third quarter.
Trying to heat up.
Alright, look at it. Go.
Sanders pass complete.
Second and 10.
Hey, bro.
You did your thing, bro.
Fans, we thank you for your attendance at tonight's game. Your Buffs return to action at Folsom Field on Saturday, November 4th against Oregon State as we celebrate homecoming. Visit CU at...
Lord, we thank you. Lord, we magnify you, glorify you. We pray that no one sustained injuries. If they did, Lord, we ask you to heal them expeditiously. Thank you for the grace, thank you for the mercies, just thank you for the gifts that you've given us that we were able to go out there and display them to the best of our ability. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Guys, as a coach and a praying coach, you can feel your team. You can feel what they're going through, you can feel where they are, you can feel your coaching staff, you can feel what's transpiring within us. And this is something I felt. That's why we put all of the 17 or 15 things up there that we need to do to win this game. You went out there, you started off just like we desired you to start. But then you got beside yourself. You start feeling yourself. You start thinking that you're better than you are. That's why we said the things we said at halftime. Now we find ourselves in a situation that we couldn't fathom. We find ourselves in a situation that you would never guess. What was the score at halftime? 29-0. And we gave up, I believe, 20 or whatever, 18 unanswered points with no response to it. You got to really make up your mind now. And that was the key word of the day. Make up your mind now. Do you really want to play this game? Like, do you really want this game to support you, to provide for you, to be your rest haven, to do the things that you want this game to do for you so you can have some of the things that you desire to have? Because right now, what I see is a bunch of guys who are in like with the game. You're not in love with the game. Because when you're in love with something, you give it everything you got. You really got to search your heart. This is coaches included. Search your heart and find out, do you love this or do you like this? Because right now you're in like with this. And the problem I have is I'm in love with this and I can't put up with the like. I walk and I look at you on the sideline and I'm sitting up there thinking, you have so much more inside of you that you're giving. Then you're giving. You're not giving everything you got. You're counting on somebody else to do the job. You count on somebody else to be there. You count on somebody else to get it done. You count on somebody else to make it happen for you. And life don't work like that. Sooner or later, you're gonna have your own responsibilities. You're not gonna be on scholarship. You're not gonna be taken care of. You're not gonna be looked after. You're not gonna have the luxuries of all this. And you're gonna have to go out there and get it on your own and work your butt off. Because ain't nobody gonna give you nothing. I don't understand. I don't think you understand what this world is consists of. What we just did today was pathetic. All the love that you received, all the love we received, oh, you getting ready to see that flip. And don't get beside yourself on social media and start responding to the foolishness, because they're right. They're right. And we practice tomorrow. God bless. Have a wonderful night.